Nigel Short, also welcome in Wijkenzee, where you've played a lot and you've won a lot.
I've won twice, anyway.
Yes. Well, for the A group, that's pretty good, I guess. But this year in Group B, how do you feel about that?
Well, it's a new experience for me. Actually, I contacted the organizers for this, and Jeroen van den Berg was a little bit surprised, actually. But he said, "Are you serious?" And I said, "Yeah, I'm serious about playing in the B group." And he said, "Well, of course, we'd be delighted to have you. It's much stronger than most of the tournaments that I participate in." So. If you look at it in a different way, you know, rather than thinking this is the B group, if you just think of it as a tournament in itself, then I'm happy to be playing in a tournament of this strength.
Yes, it's amazingly strong with I think 2,700 players, and a lot of strength.
Didn't study exactly, but it is a strong event.
Yes. Do you think you can have a chance for promoting to the A group?
Well, I think a lot depends on how I start the event. I'm certainly capable of winning this event. However, last year I played so badly that I'm not thinking so ambitiously. I would like to just put in a good result. And this will be, you know, I want to steady myself and put in a good result. You know, if I were to finish in the top three, this would be tremendous. So, yes, I am capable of winning, but I'll have to play very, very well indeed. And right now, I'm not thinking of that. I'm thinking one game at a time. I have a tough game tomorrow against Hare Krishna. And we'll see how it goes.
Okay, last question before your bus leaves.
Yeah.
What went wrong in Kantimans Siska, and what are you going to do differently right here?
Well, this sort of format of an event is not very serious as far as I'm concerned. When you start mixing disciplines, you have classical chess, rapid chess, blitz chess. This is not a proper event. And there were special circumstances in Hantimansisk. I didn't have great ambitions. I was just hoping to get through to the second round. I've had various disappointments before in this type of event. So, it was very unfortunate. My opponent arrived absurdly late for
the rapid game, right?
Yeah, the rapid game. He arrived more than 24 minutes late for a 25-minute game. I think the guy should simply be forfeited for this. That this is way too long. I also think that 1 hour is a completely ridiculous forfeit time for classical chess, and that it should be maximum 15 minutes. I think if you're not there 15 minutes after the start of play, then just bad luck. In other sports, you have to be there on the dot. And, you know, if you show up late for a game of tennis, tough luck. And I think
so perhaps in rapid, something like 5 minutes or something, and that's it.
Yeah, I think something like that. So, there are biochemical reasons why my opponent would have had an advantage. From the moment he woke up, he knew he was going to be playing bullet chess. For me, I have preparedness at the beginning of play, but as the time is ticking by, this is going down and down and down and down. You know, whereas he is absolutely pumped up. And it's very difficult to adjust to something like this. So I don't think he did it deliberately. I don't think it was gamesmanship. But I simply don't think it should be allowed. It's not. If everybody showed up 24 minutes late at this event, then you cannot call chess a sport anymore. You know, thousands of people watching live on the internet, and I think we have to take ourselves seriously. And these rules are antiquated, and it's time to change them. I think they will change them, actually, because I know they have already discussed this in Antalya.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and good luck.